Hi friends, welcome back. Today we are going to solve LeetCode problem 732, my calendar 3. Before we go and look into the problem description and some examples, I just want to mention that my channel is focused on helping people who are preparing for coding interviews and Java interviews. On my channel, there are more than 200 solved examples explained with Java code, and those coding problems are taken from like previously asked questions by big tech companies like Amazon, Apple, Facebook, Microsoft, Google, Yahoo, and many others. Those are handpicked problems to cover a wide range of important varieties from coding interview perspective, such as dynamic programming, linked list, string related questions, graph related interview coding problems, binary search problems, binary search tree related problems, BFS, DFS problems, as well as matrix related problems. So if you are preparing for coding interviews or Java interviews, please subscribe to the channel now. So let's look into this problem statement of my calendar 3. A K booking happens when K events have some non-empty intersection. That is, there is some time that is common to all K events. You are given some events which is start and end. After each given event, return an integer k representing the maximum k booking between all the previous events. So we have to return maximum k booking that we have seen in including all the past events, right? So implement mycalendar3 class, and this is the constructor that is given us, and we have to implement the book method which has a start and end as parameters, right? Returns an integer k representing largest integer such that there exists k booking in the calendar, which means that we have to find out the basically for all the past intervals that are given to us, we have to find out the k events, right? Which are the events, maximum number of k, which are intersecting events, basically we have to return, right? So they have given us this one example. Here they have given us constraints where 0 is less than equal to start is less than end is less than equal to 10^9, and at most 400 calls will be made to the book method that we have to implement, right? This book method. So let's take this example over here and we will discuss. So first let's just go and we can so this is the input that is given to us. Let me choose a color here. So this is the input that is given to us. So we have been given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 events, and we have to return the k booking, right, for each of these events, right? So for example, this is the timeline that I drew, you know, for each event. So for example, 10:20, right? So 10:20 is this event. So when this event comes, there is no other events, and this is a disjoint event, right? So there are no other events. So we have to return one here, right? Basically in that case, when there is another event comes 50:60. So this is 50:60 event, right? Again, so we have seen this event already. So this event we have seen, right? This is the one event that we have seen. This is the second event that we are seeing. Now, as you can see, there is no intersection between 1 and 2. Those are disjoint, right? No intersection. So again, we have to return 1 because they are disjoint. And now the next one is 10:40, right? So 10:40 is this event basically, right? This is the third event, which is starting at 10 and ending at 40. So as you can see, it is intersecting with 1, right? So if I draw a line like this, it is intersecting with 1. So there are two events now which are intersecting with each other, right? So in this case, we have to return 2 here, right? So we are returning 2 for this. So after 10:40, the next event is 5:15. So 5:15 is this event. So this is number 4, right? This is number 4. It goes from 5:15. And as you can see, if we draw a line like this basically, right, this is the line. If we draw, then we are intersecting with 1, 3 and 4. So all these three events got intersected, so the k value will be 3 in this case. So 3 we will have to return in this case, right? So we have seen 5:15, now we are seeing 5:10, right? So this one is 5:10, right? This one is 5:10. So this is number 5th now, fifth event we are seeing. So now if we look at what is the maximum k value that we have seen from starting until this event, so the k value is again 3 basically, right? As we have seen, these three intersections are intersecting with each other, right? So that is why we have to return 3 here, right? And after that, the last event is 25 to 55. So 25 to 55, I marked it here. So this one is the sixth event, right? And still the maximum intersection that is possible is again this intersection, right? Which is intersection of 3 events, 4, 3 and 1, right? It goes through all these 3 events. That is the maximum intersection which is possible, right? So that is why we have to return 3 here again. So this is what the problem is basically. So we have to, whenever we are booking for any event, we have to return the maximum k which we, including all the past events, right? So that is the problem. So let's move through the now solution and how we are going to implement this problem or solve this problem. So I again took the same example over here. So in this case, we are going to use tree map to solve this problem, my calendar 3. So why we are using tree map? Because tree map gives us a sorted order of map for the keys, right? Because the keys are in the sorted order. Now the keys for our example is the starting of the event and ending at the event, right? Those are the keys, and we are associating a value for starting of the event. We will associate value 1, and if the event is ending, then we will associate value -1 for that in the tree map, right? So let's go through this example so you will understand how we can solve this problem with tree map. So let's say 10, 20, let's consider this event. So we will go ahead and let's just make one map here, right? And let's just go through this example. Okay, so the first is 10 to 20, right? So this is the event. So let's say this event starts. So we will say 10 and the value will be 1, right? 10 is 1 and it is ending at 20. So let's say 20, 20 value will be minus 1, right? The ending is -1, the starting is 1. So ending is -1 here, right? So after we have made these entries, then we will move, we will go through the map, right? And we will check each and every entry. So let's, we will create one variable like a sum, let's call it sum, and one other variable, let's just call it result, right, for now. So this is the result variable, okay? And then, we will read this entries from the tree map and we will add that into the sum. So now once we add, once we see 10, 1, we will add a sum to 1, and whatever sum is the maximum, we will always capture that into the result, right? So result is maximum. So now 1, so we updated our result to 1. When we look at 20 minus 1, then this 1 minus 1 again it becomes 0, right? 1 plus minus 1 again it becomes 0, and our result is 1 at this time, right? So whatever our result is, we will just return. So here, as you can see, the result, like this value is 1 here, right? So now let's take the second event, 50 to 60. So now again we will make some entries here, right? So one entry we will add is for 50. 50 will be 1, let's say, right? And 60 is the ending of the event, right? 60 is the ending, so it is -1. So after this one is done, we will again go through all these entries from the map. So so 10 means, again, let's say the 10 means sum is 0 in the beginning. So sum becomes 1, right? We will not update result because result is already 1. We will only update result when sum becomes more than result, right? So now 20 comes. So 1 minus 1, again, now it becomes 0, right? 1 minus 1, again it becomes 0. Now 50 comes, so 0 plus 1 again becomes 1, right? And 1 and 60 is minus 1. 1 minus 1 again becomes 0, right? In this case, result will be 1 only because the maximum value we have seen is 1. So again, we will return 1 here, right? So now the third event comes, right? 10, 40 is the third event. So now we will look into value of 10. So now we will update 10 from 1 to 2, right? 1 is there, so we will update it because we are seeing 10 second time, so we will update it to 2. 40 is minus 1 again. So now let's say we have 40 here, right? And 40 will be minus 1 because ending is always minus 1. So after this one is done, we will again go through these all these elements in the tree map and we will calculate sum. So sum is 0 in the beginning. So 0 plus 2 is 2, right? 2. So now we will update result to 2 because 2 is more than 1, right? So we will update it to 2. Then after 2, minus 1 means 2 minus 1 is 1. Now 1 minus 1 is again 0, right? And 0 plus 1 again is 1. And 1 minus this again minus 1 is 1 minus 1 is 0, right? Now maximum value we had seen in this case is 2, right? So we updated result to 2 and we will return 2 here basically, right? So that is the logic. So after that 515 comes. So we will just make an entry here, 5, we will put 1 here, right? And 15, we will put minus 1 here, right? 15 is because it's an ending thing, so ending of the event, so minus 1, right? Now again, so now I'll just write the sum and result here, right? Because now there is no space at the bottom, so I'll just write it here. So now we'll again start iterating through all these values, all these keys from the tree map, and we will get the values and we will calculate sum. So now 5 means 0 plus 1 means 1, 1 plus 2 means 3, right? So 3 is more than this current result, right? Current result is 2, so we will update it to 3. And now we will keep calculating. So 3 minus 1 minus 1 minus 1, right? So 3 times minus 1 means it became 0 basically, right? And after that 1 means it became 1, and 1 minus last one is minus 1, so it became 0 here, right? So maximum value we had seen is 3, so 3 we will return as our answer here. So 3 is the answer here, right? Okay, so now we had seen 515, now we are seeing 510, right? So 510 means we will update 5 from 1 to 2, right? And 10 is we will update 10 is 2 minus 1 because now this is the ending of the event. So we will add that minus 1 into 2, right? So 2 minus 1 basically, which becomes 1 here, correct? So that's what the current status of our tree map is. Again, we will iterate through all these keys and we will calculate sum. So let's again calculate sum now. So now sum is 2, 0 plus 1 is 2, right? So 2 we added, then 2 plus this 1 is, it became 3. So 3, now we still did not update result because it's already showing 3 here, right? So 3 is our sum. So after that, as you can see, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, 3 times, right? So it 3 becomes 0 basically. And then we added 1 and minus 1, which means 1, and then minus 1 means 0 basically, right? The maximum value we had seen during this traversal is 3, right? So 3 we had seen, so 3 we will return as our answer here, right? And then 25, 55. So we will add 25 here. So 25, and the value will be 1 here for 25 because it's starting, and for 55 the value will be minus 1, right? Because it is ending of the event. So why we are adding between 20 and 40? Because always tree map will keep these values in keys in sorted order, right? So that's why. So this is always sorted, right? And that is very important, and that is why we are using tree map. So now we will again go through all these keys and we will calculate sum. So for example, we'll start with 5. So 2 plus 1 is 3. So 3 we have, right? 3 we have. Still we did not update our result because the result is already having maximum value 3 here during this transition, right? Translation. So after this 3, then we have minus 1 minus 1. So 3 minus 2 basically, which becomes 1, right? Then 1 plus 1, it again becomes 2. 1 plus 1 became 2. And 2 minus 1 is, so 2 plus 1, 3. 3 minus this 2 became 1. And now 1 plus 1 is 2 and minus 1, right? 2 minus 1 is 1. And 1 plus 1 is 2. and 2 minus this minus 1 minus 1. 2 minus 2 is 0, right? So always we make sure that the sum is always come to 0 at the end. Because why? Because every event starts and ends, right? So plus 1 and minus 1 basically gets balanced. That's why it's always ends with 0. So during this traversal, we have seen maximum value as 3, right? As you can see. So 3 we will return as our answer. We will always hold the maximum value in our result variable. So this is the way we can solve this MyCalendar 3 problem with the help of tree map. So let's look into the implementation details now. So let's look into the implementation. So I just created a private tree map of integer comma integer, and I just initialized it into the constructor. Here is our book method, which takes start and end. So we will put start and end. So for start, we will always put plus 1. If a value exists, we will put plus 1 to that value. If value exists for the end, we will always use minus 1, right? So as I shown in the example. And then we created in progress events variable here. So basically in progress events is the result variable that we saw here, right? So sum is 0. Sum is always 0, right? And then we will update, like we will iterate through map.values, right? Map.values we will get. Because values, why? Because with this we'll get 1, 2, minus 1, all these values, right? We will get these values basically, right? And we will update through it, and we will calculate, keep calculating sum, and we will keep track of it in progress. This is the math.max we use, right? To get the maximum. So at the end, we will return the maximum after adding the booking, right? So that is what the K booking means basically. We wanted to find out the maximum that we had seen so far basically. So the implementation is very straightforward once you understand the concept of how it works here. So let's go ahead and let's just test our code quickly on this one. This is the first example that they had given us. So as you can see, our test case is passing. So that is the only one. So now we can just go ahead and submit our solution. Our solution got accepted by LeetCode. It is 75% faster than other submissions and 59% faster on the memory usage. So this is the way we can solve MyCalendar 3 problem. This is an important problem conceptually to understand how we can solve a calendar problem with the help of tree map. And we use tree map because tree map holds the keys in the sorted order. And we gave like a plus 1 for starting and minus 1 for the ending of every event to calculate the, you know, total K booking values basically. So if you haven't already looked into my playlist, there is a separate playlist called as LeetCode and LeetCode Solutions, which has over 200 solved examples taken from previously asked coding interview questions by big tech companies like Amazon, Apple, Facebook, Microsoft, Google, Yahoo, and many others. And those problems are handpicked to cover important varieties such as dynamic programming, graph problems, binary search tree problems, binary search related coding interview questions, linked list questions, string related coding questions, BFS, DFS, matrix problems, as well as priority queue and optimization problems. So if you are preparing for coding interviews or just preparing for Java initial rounds of screening as well as telephonic interviews, please subscribe to the channel. This channel can definitely help you preparing for your solution in a better way. And also your subscription is really important to us because this is the way the videos can reach to more people who are preparing for coding interviews, and they can look into these solved examples and get helped in understanding these concepts and get helped in their interview preparation. So please subscribe to the channel, and thanks for watching the video.